The Bible teaches everything we want to know.
That's right.
God is having a conversation with Joshua.
Mm-hmm. All right. Come on there.
After the death of Moses, God is talking to Joshua.
All right.
Because what Joshua wanted to know was, what do I do from this point on? And God is telling Joshua, giving Joshua some instruction. Only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest do, observe and do according to all my servant Moses hath commanded you.
Mm-hmm.
Don't turn from it to the right hand or to the left. And then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success.
Yes.
Now, God's instruction to Joshua is the same instruction he gave us. Follow Moses. Now, who really was Moses? Moses represents the successful formula, the successful woman. When you want to be successful, you have to what? Find somebody successful and do what?
Yeah.
How could God give Joshua that instruction if there was no Moses?
Mm-hmm. Right.
Let's say there was no Moses. Mm-hmm. What God gonna tell Joshua then? Ain't nothing to tell him. Right? Because he don't have a successful formula. Let me give you an example. What I'm talking about. The Wright brothers invented a machine that could fly in the air. Before them, it wasn't no machine that could fly there. It wasn't no machine. We lived thousands of years on this earth, and we didn't have no machine that fly that could fly there.
Mm-hmm.
Then these boys called the Wright brothers, build this machine, and what did the machine do? Pass it.
Fly.
It flew. Right? So, I don't know the Wright brothers. But I want a machine that flies in the air. What do I do? Copy the Wright brothers.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
All I got to do, because the Wright brothers are who? Moses, as far as the machine that flies is concerned. They're the ones that know how to do it. God's instruction is follow Moses. If you want to be successful or flying around here as much, do what? Follow Moses, right? Follow the one that know how to do it. If you follow the one that know how to do it, the Bible says, then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. But you got to have a Moses. A man wanted to have a machine that he could sit in this room right here and talk to his grandmama in Mississippi. Right?
Yeah.
People say, you crazy. That can't happen. You can't sit in one room in Dallas, Texas and talk to your grandmama in another room in Mississippi.
Right?
You insane. But he kept working and working, and then we had a machine called the telephone.
Yeah.
We ain't never had no telephone before him. His name was Bad. He was the Moses of sitting in your living room talking to your grandma in Mississippi.
All right.
So I come along and I want to talk to my grandma in Mississippi. What do I do?
Follow
Moses. Right?
Yeah.
Bell was Moses. I don't have to try to invent me no machine. Right? He already done invented this thing.
Yeah.
All I got to do is what?
Follow
Moses. Right? Only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest do according to all my servant commanded you.
Yeah.
Now I'm gonna show you something. I got a book here. My grandson.
Yeah, it's good.
It's called 33 Questions About American History That You're Not Supposed to Ask. See, he don't care nothing about
me.
Me preaching.
Right? It's good.
When he get ready, you know, I'm running for office.
Yeah.
You know, politicians go around kissing babies. I'm going to bring my own baby. This is 33 questions about American history that you're not supposed to ask. A white man wrote this. And in this book, question 32 is, who is S.B. Fuller? Now, let me tell you, S.B. Fuller is the Moses for black people. He is the Moses for black people. In America, black people are the poorest people in the country. We the poorest people in America. Black people. This man, S.B. Fuller, was a black man out of Louisiana. He had a sixth grade education. Didn't have no education. And he said he prayed to God. God, give me wisdom. And God gave him wisdom.
Amen.
He said, if God will give me wisdom, he said, I'm going to build a multi-million dollar business. God going to give me the wisdom to do it. And when I do it, I'm going to show other men and women how to do the same thing. I'm going to be the Moses for the prosperity of black people. This is Black History Month. But suppose there ain't no Moses. Suppose there ain't no Moses. What is Joshua to do? Right? We don't have a Moses for prosperity in the black community. We have one, but we don't know nothing about it. Because this white man recognized 33 questions about American history, you ain't supposed to ask. You ain't supposed to know nothing about your Moses. And you don't know nothing about it. I bet you ain't two people here that ever heard of S.B. Fuller. Right? Because they don't promote S.B. Fuller. They don't celebrate S.B. Fuller. They don't talk to you about who got the answer for you to have prosperity in this country. They don't talk to you about that. They say you have been mistreated. You have been discriminated against. People don't like you. And you should march, protest, demonstrate, cuss out other people. But when you get to doing all that, are you going to have some prosperity for you and your children? That's what we want, don't we? Don't we want our kids to have better clothes? Live in a better house? Go to better school? Don't we want that? Then only be thou strong and very courageous that thou mayest observe and do according to who? Moses. Now, I got a plane, y'all. And I want to go somewhere in this plane. There's somebody that don't know how to fly no plane. Say, listen, I'm going to pilot this plane for you. You getting on that plane?
No.
How come? oh no, right? Because you know you're going to be in trouble, right? You cannot follow somebody that don't know how to do what they need to be doing, right? So here's Fuller. I'm saying Fuller is the Moses for our prosperity. How can we prove that he is? Jesus said, by their fruit. You should know this. If he know how to create prosperity for folk, he creates some for himself. Right? In 1958, U.S. News and World Report reported that this black, uneducated black boy out of Louisiana, his hitchhiked his way from Memphis to Chicago, was the richest black man in America. Richest black man in America. And let me tell you what happened after that. If I know how to do something, if you want to know how to fly a plane, who do you learn how to do it from? Somebody didn't know how to do it, right? You go to school, right? Your kid needs to learn math. Who do you learn math from? Somebody that know math, right? Anything. want to know, you better find somebody, what? That know how to do that thing. And how do you know that person know how to do it? Because they do it. Jesus said, by their fruit. That man get up, go on the plane, zoop, zoop, fly around, come back down, and say, well, he know how to do that. I can learn from him because why? He know how to do it, and if he know how to do it, he can show me how to do it. Right? He can't show me how to do it if he don't know how to do it. So here, Mr. Fuller, little sixth grade education, black man out of Louisiana, go to Chicago, take $25, build a multi-million dollar business. The richest black man in America, we ain't never heard of, because they want to keep the knowledge of Moses from you. Because if you know about Moses, what you going to do? Follow him. You're going to follow him, right? And if you follow him, then the Bible says, you're going to have good success. Then thou shalt make thy way prosperous. But they don't want you to be prosperous. They don't want you to have good success. These kids, like little Susie, she knew that Jonah was swallowed whole. And can't nobody talk her out of it.
Right.
And when our kids know that they can have prosperity in their life, ain't nobody gonna be able to talk them out of it.
That's right.
That's why you ain't supposed to know about S.B. Fuller. And how do I know about S.B. Fuller? I met the man. I worked for the man. He changed my life. I was on my way to Thug Beat. I was gonna be. You heard that song out, Get Yourself a Thug? I was on my way to Thug Beat. I had me a gun, had a 357 Magnum, carried around with me. And, Doc, I brought my man down. Yeah, on my way to Thugville, and I met this black man named Moses. Say, Negro, you the dumbest little Negro I ever seen. I said, he talking to me like this? He said, boy, you need to learn something so you can be somebody in life. You got to stop blaming other people. And I stopped blaming other people, and I listened to him, and I followed him, and some other people did too. We got a company, a black man, a black boy. I'm telling you, I can go back, I can just talk for 5 more minutes, I'll be good. But this black boy in Chicago dropped out of high school age 16. What happened to a black boy dropped out of high school age 16? That's the end of him. And that's what? He found Moses. This boy found S.B. Fuller, a high school dropout, 16 years old. Mr. Fuller worked with that boy, directed that boy, and corrected that boy. We don't have folk that can take our boys and direct them and what? And correct them. Right? These mothers are pulling their hair out because they don't know what to do with that boy. Right? We got that boy. You know, the Bible says everything reproduces at his own hand. Daddy was a thug. He had his boy. Guess what? He on the way to Thugville too. Daddy was sorry and lazy. Guess what's gonna happen to that boy? He's gonna be sorry and lazy. That's why the Bible says you gotta repent. You gotta say, my daddy was sorry and lazy, and I'm gonna repent him. I ain't gonna be sorry and lazy like my dad. My daddy was drunk. I'm gonna repent my daddy. I ain't drinking. My daddy likes to smoke even some dope. I'm gonna repent my daddy. I ain't touching no dope. Right. You gotta repent. And you gotta have a Moses the father. Right? This 16-year-old boy, Mr. Fuller trained him. When he was 26, he started the company. Y'all probably gonna use some of the product. It's called Ultrasheen. Y'all use some Ultrasheen? You can't find no black person that have never used some Ultrasheen. In 1975, they gave Mr. Fuller a bank. This boy got up on stage and said, if it had been no you, She was talking to Mr. Fuller. If it had been no you, Mr. Fuller, there would be no me.
All right.
Right? There would be no Joshua if it was no Moses.
That's right.
You got to have a Moses for a Joshua to follow. Who our kids follow? Can we protest our way to prosperity? No. We've been protesting a long time. We cuss our people. We've been doing that a long time. We've been talking about been discriminated against, and we do a lot of that. Have we achieved prosperity? Have we achieved success? Because we ain't following Joshua. I ain't making this up now. Look in your Bible and see what the conversation is, the first chapter of Joshua. God is telling Joshua, whatever you do, don't turn from the right hand and don't turn to the left hand. Don't add your thing to it and don't take your thing away from it. This lady goes down to the state fair and she had a German chocolate cake and she got the blue ribbon. Best German chocolate cake in the state of Texas. Can she teach me how to make that cake? Now I can't boil water without burning it. Can she teach me how to make that cake? She will be the Moses to me for the success of that cake. She say, put one stick of butter in this cake. I say, I like my cake kind of rich. I'm going to put two sticks. She said, use 2 cups of sugar. I said, I like my cake kind of sweet. I'm going to have 4 cups of sugar. My cake. Am I going to get the blue ribbon?
No.
That stuff going to be so nasty. In order for me to get a cook a cake like her, right? I got to do what? What the Bible says, Joshua. Follow her. Don't add nothing to her recipe. Don't take nothing away from her recipe. And I'm going to have me what? A good cake. Mr. Fuller was a prophet. He showed George Johnson, Usher Sheen, how to be prophet. So George Johnson, listen. He followed. Wow. I'll tell you one more thing, then I'm gone. There was another black boy on welfare. The welfare truck was coming up to his house, bringing him some pound, eggs, cheese. You know how good that cheese is, right?
Yeah.
He was on the corner with some of his friends.
Yeah.
And one of his friends said, man, the welfare truck pulling up to your house. He said, they ain't going to my house. He was ashamed. Mr. Fuller got a hold of that young boy. Talked that boy, trained that boy. And that boy started a publishing firm called Johnson Publications. They produced Ebony and Jet Magazine.
Oh,
okay. Right? Mm-hmm. Now, you hear them becoming these black people on, you don't know the man behind it, right? You don't know Fuller. They don't want you to know Fuller because they don't want Fuller to do for you what he done for them. Right? How about you never heard the name? You don't come on TV say Black History Month, here's that big Fuller. They get some other people for you to follow. Uh-huh. Right? Listen to some protesters, some demonstrators. So we say, yeah, this was our great leader. He protested, cussing our white people. But when we get to cussing our white people, what we got? Ain't got nothing, because the instruction that God gave to Joshua, that's the instruction. We better learn how to follow. And we better find us a Moses for prosperity. And that's who S.B. Fuller was and is. Find out about him. Go home. Google S.B. Fuller. Go on YouTube. See who S.B. Fuller is. What he talked about, what his philosophy was. And if you follow that, what the Bible say? Then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. Listen, I love y'all. I'm so thankful for you coming. We got Reverend Gibson. We got some good music we're going to have. And I have said my little piece. Thank you, everybody.